want to talk a little bit about a few things, actually. One of them being, you know, we're going to jump back on the gaming scene, and I'm just going to, you know, go over some real quick things, man, that I missed, you know, during the E3 scenario or situation that just happened. A couple games, you know, went under the radar. Actually, one of them wasn't even talked about at E3. They weren't even there. I just found this, stumbled upon this game, trying to figure out something from another game. And this game is actually now considered one of my most sought after games. And I can't wait to get into this game, but we're going to get into that in a second. Let's talk about first the first game on my list right now, which I saw some footage of. And there's actually a footage of the first boss fight, and it got me really, really excited to see this game, because I actually am enjoying the first one. And that is The Surge 2. Now, The Surge 2 basically is The Surge 1, but it takes place, you know, in a different atmosphere. The graphics look to be slightly improved, and from the footage that I saw, it looked to be the character had actually some projectile weapons or projectile attacks. So in the first one, you know, you didn't have any projectile abilities, but this one here, you actually have some sort of projectile that you could use. He was holding a axe of some sort, and I guess he was shooting bullets from it, like a shotgun, almost, if you will, which looked pretty cool. The boss fight was actually pretty cool too, but the environment and atmosphere on this game was definitely more open, if you will. It wasn't in like a facility, a closed kind of like a machine based facility like the first one was in, even though I did really like that scene and I really did like the way that game was laid out. But this one here is just, you get a more open feel to it. And excuse my voice, just woke up, nose a little stuffy, but just bear with me, guys. We're gonna get this shit done. As I was saying about The Surge 2, check it out. Check out the footage. The boss fight was pretty epic. It was short, but it was dope. It was about a 4-minute video, what I saw. And it's also, this game, you're going to actually be able to create your own character in this one. The other one, you know, you had to use the main protagonist, which was cool. And, you know, it was story. But this one, you get to create your own character. And I'm interested to see how that, you know, how that transitions into this game. It looks like to be a total upgrade from the first one. And this one is definitely going to be a play for me, The Surge 2. Now, the last thing I'll say about this Surge 2 game is I hope that they give us some kind of closure to the first Surge and what happened to, you know, the protagonist of that game, because that game was left open ended. And nobody really knows what happened to him. You know what I mean? So basically, you know, I guess I'm only assuming that the people that, you know, were in Surge 1, they weren't just in that facility. Maybe some got out and escaped and, you know, expanded, you know, outside of, you know, the facility. And that's why we have this game here. But hopefully that will be divulged to us, you know, later at a later time, you know, in the story. And as, you know, more and more press for this game starts to come out. But 2019 is what everybody's saying for the release. So it's still a little ways out, but it's just something to look forward to if you guys are into The Surge or not, and like I am. So definitely be looking out for that. Another game I want to talk about a little bit, man, that kind of caught my eye, reminded me of a Dark Souls slash anime. Basically, like if anime was a Dark Souls game. And that game is Code Vein. Code, C-O-D-E, Vein, V-E-I-N. Yeah, man, it looks just like, it plays just like, you know, a Dark Souls game, but like with anime, you know, characters. Like the character creation looks dope. It looks very, very doable. Male, female, on this one, you even have a little bit more freedom. Well, nah, fuck that. You have just as much freedom, if not more. I'd say more freedom on the creation side of things when it comes to your character in this game here. Game looks extremely cool. I'm going to look more into it, but I've seen some gameplay and, you know, I like it. I like where they're going with it. And, you know, it's something that I'd definitely be looking forward to, something that I would definitely play. When I learn a little bit more about it, I'm sure, you know, some other things will be lifted, other shadows, you know, and I'll be, you know, more than happy to bring that to you guys' attention. But for right now, from what I've seen, it looks to be a pretty dope game, and it looks to be something that I would definitely fucking pick up and play. Code Vein, if you haven't heard of it, go check it out. Yeah, a game that basically fuses Dark Souls with the anime world as far as the cosmetics. And, you know, hey, check it out, guys. Okay, there's another game. There's a fighting game out here in these streets, man. And this game here, you know, I've never heard of it. Never heard of it. An amazing thing about about the internet now and about, you know, the gaming world, you know, even the anime world, is the fact that there's so many of them out there now. And you can easily pass, miss, walk over any number of different anime or any number of different games and not even fucking know and discover it till later. And it's been right under your nose this whole time. And half of them you find by clicking on something else, and you end up stumbling upon another video about something else that you catches your eye and you're interested in or whatever. So it's crazy that it works that way. But I love that fact. You know, finding those treasures, those hidden gems, you know, and having shit on your nose and not even knowing it, like Naruto for me. I mean, I fucking, you know, a year ago, you know, it's been about a year since I've, you know, seen Naruto, maybe a little less. And up until that time, I have never seen Naruto. I've seen it. I've heard people talk about it and gush over it. But I was a Dragon Ball guy, so I was just like, you know, okay. But boy, I'm so glad that I fucking decided to sit down and give Naruto a chance, because I fucking love that anime. It's like one of my favorites now. It's up there with Dragon Ball. And I just, that's just a side tangent. But let me get back to, you know, this next game. But this game is a fighting game, okay, and it's called Blade Strangers. It's supposed to be a multi-platform game, coming to most all systems. It's using a shaded type of technology graphic, kind of like when you think of Dragon Ball Fighters. It's kind of got that feel graphically to it, but it's anime style. The characters are anime, you know, drawn. And it looks very interesting. The characters look very awesome, and the fighting looks extremely dope. And everybody has like some sort of weapon, some sort of handheld weapon, sword, or if you will. It looks really fucking dope. And then I've heard it's got a whole bunch of modes, training modes, and all these things. So it looks to be pretty beefy in that. And when you play fighting games, that's what you fucking want. I mean, you want a fighting game not to come out like Street Fighter and fuck you and bend you over and then put the money on the table and walk out the door. And do you like that when they first drop it? You know, minimum amount of characters, no modes, no arcade mode. I mean, none of this shit. So this game is not that. This game is going to give, you know, give us some things to play around with and do. And, you know, I think I'm going to be playing this one. I definitely love my fighting games, and especially some unique ones. And this seems to be a very unique fighting game, and I can't wait to dive deeper into this one and check it out. As far as the release date is concerned, I'm not quite sure when that is going to happen, but I will keep you guys posted. I don't want to give you guys any false information on that, but definitely, you guys, if you like fighters, if you want to check out a new take on it, a different look, a different angle, something cool, in my opinion, then definitely check out Blade Strangers. Check that shit out. Now, the game I want to get to next is the game that really, really caught me off guard, and this game wasn't even at E3. The same company who is responsible for making I think it's the Darksiders series. They have a Darksiders 3 coming out, and it's got a female protagonist in it, and it looks fucking awesome. But they are the same people who've done this game. And that game wasn't shown at E3 either, because, you know, they claim that I guess GameCon is going to be their next venture, because they supposedly they're big soccer fans or whatever. And, you know, they were attending some major event, and, you know, E3 was not important enough for them to attend. So for whatever reason, OK. But a friend of mine put me on this game, and he was talking about it. And I, you know, out of his mouth, it didn't sound too intriguing until I actually, you know, looked it up and I had to check it out. And the game was called Biomutant. Now, if you haven't heard of Biomutant, man, it's one of those games that are just basically under the radar. And I went into GameStop one day, and I was talking to one of the guys, and he said, "Do you have anything you want to pre-order or anything like that?" And I was like, not really. I'm a game head, but I'm really looking forward to Biomutant. And he was like, oh, shit. You know about Biomutant. Not many people know about that one. And, you know, rightfully so. I mean, for whatever reason, I don't know if it's the press. I don't know if because everything is being overshadowed by Darkstalkers or Darksiders 3 or what. But this game is going to be the fucking truth. I want to play this game. This game is basically about some sort of mutant being, beast, or whatever. The closest thing I can kind of give you to kind of like a, he looks kind of like a wolf, a wolf slash dog or whatever kind of creature. You know, he's furry, you know, he's got fur on him and stuff like that. And he's got this big ass sword on his back, basically. And it's an open world RPG, action RPG. And it reminds me of kind of like a Zelda-esque world. It looks fucking amazing. I like the graphical style. It's got a different look to it, man. I mean, and as far as even the little quirkies, the little quirks in the game, when you hit people for certain combos and shit like that, you know, you see the big bam and the pow, kind of like you see in the comic books. That kind of effect goes on in there, and then you know, it's got a dark tone to it as well. You know what I mean? When you kill these enemies and stuff like that. And I love the way that they do their weapons. I mean, you can fly in this game. You can attain items to help you fly. You can attain items to basically, you have a sword, but you also have the ability to make guns and long distance projectile weapons, all kinds, all sorts. So you gather all these different pieces and you can pretty much custom make your own weapons, including melee weapons. It doesn't have to be a sword. I've seen some shit like I've seen a stick of wood with like nails in it. Variations of that. I've seen some strange things, weapon wise, man. I've seen like a piece of a gun with other pieces connected to it. Words cannot describe, you know, this game. You definitely have to check out the video, or the videos that are out there. It is called Biomutant and it is an open world RPG. My favorite genre of game to play. And it looks to be amazing, man. This guy, the game looks to just be amazing. I love the darkness of it, the dark tone. I love the little quirkiness that it has. It's basically got its own. I haven't never seen anything like it. It's its own game. So it's intriguing in that sense alone by itself, not even talking about the other stuff. I mean, when you see games like this, you just know like, okay, this is something different. This is something it's its own game. You know what I mean? I have not seen this. They really made it their own game. When you see this game, going forward, you'll know that, you know, this is a Biomutant game. So anything that comes out after that is you'd be comparing it to maybe some things from this game. This is a dope game, guys. Check it out. And you also have the ability to, you know, basically create your own character. You can create, he's still a mutant and you know, in a sense, but you can make him look how you want to make him look. There no two mutants will look the same. And also you can shape the body, so you can make it, you know, skinny and slim and tall, or you can make it kind of husky and short. And as you do that, it scales, you know, your abilities from the start of the game. So in other words, if you make them short and kind of stocky, you on the side of the screen, you actually see the attributes as far as the strength and stuff like that go up. And if you make him taller and slim and more slinky, you see his speed go up and you see other things, you know, change in on the chart. So you start out like that, and then, you know, you could probably make a, you know, a tank build starting out, and then you could spec into, you know, you can spec into other things as you progress and as you level up. So to balance it out, if you will. So you can do all kind of shit with it, man. If you want to be a melee guy, strictly a more of a melee guy, close guy, you can spec into that. You can acquire weapons like that. And these weapons have effects on them. I mean, poison, fire. I mean, it's fucking nasty. I'm telling you guys, it's sick, and I can't wait to play it. Number one, because it's so unique and I've never seen anything like it. Number two, because I love open world RPGs, you know, Zelda, Ocarina of Time. I mean, classic. I mean, you know, The Witcher, God of War, you know, Horizon Zero Dawn, you know, games like this are fucking, you know, amazing to me. I love the open world, and, you know, and you can approach this game how you want to approach it. The developers have spoke on this. You know, you can take it how you want to take it. You can go the evil route or you can go the good route, and different things, of course, happen if you take certain routes in this game. So I'm definitely looking forward to playing this. Biomutant is awesome. And you actually, your body adapts to, you know, the situations from what they've shown us so far. They haven't shown us a lot, but in other words, case in point, give you an example. When he's starting to run, okay, he walks on, you know, just 2 feet or whatever, but he's a mutant. So when he needs to get really fast, his body takes on a more of a four-legged kind of thing. He doesn't necessarily morph physically. His body just adjusts and begins to run on all fours, and he gains more speed that way, and he's faster. A lot of different things like that, or like say he's in water and he's swimming or whatever, but his whole body won't change, but his feet and hands will kind of develop a fin type shape, and it will help him swim faster, you know, things like that. Now, I don't know how elaborate they get with this. It could get more physical. We could be seeing on a more physical aspect as we get further into the game, but from what I've seen so far, that is not the case, and who knows what's going to happen in this game. Like, open world RPGs, man, are usually, you know, hours upon hours to complete. So you know, we're going to find all kind of hidden gems in this game, and I'm looking forward to this. The release date on this game, from the last time I checked, was supposed to be the last day of 2018. So December 31st, you know what I mean? So I'm definitely getting this game here, guys, and I encourage everyone who hasn't heard of this game, Biomutant, to check it out. I would love to hear your comments on this game. Definitely holler at your boy on social media, at Twitter at Studio MacGyver, or, you know, on Facebook page at Studio MacGyver, or Instagram, Studio MacGyver 79. Holler at your boy, man, with that. Yeah, looking forward to hearing what you guys think about this game. All right, now moving on. We're going to jump on Nintendo. Yes, Nintendo for Two Shakes of a Lamb's Tale, because, you know, they've got some things brewing in the pot. And, you know, I thought I'd mention this, you know what I mean? You know, I love pixel art games. I'm a sucker for pixel art games, and, you know, it's just my thing. But they got a few of those coming out, man. One I have to mention, and this is a multi-platform game. It's coming out, I think, not just for Nintendo Switch, but, you know, this is something I'd play strictly on Nintendo Switch. It's a game called Blasphemous. And it's supposed to be coming out sometime in November, and it's an indie game, and I think they really found something here with this game here, man. All I'm going to say is check it out. It's a very fucking dark game. And, you know, it's unique. And I'm just a sucker for those type of games. I'm not going to, you know, go too far into it, but there's not too much we really know about it. I've seen some gameplay, it's betas being tested and all this, but it's called Blasphemous. Check it out. It's coming out for all platforms. Let's jump to the next. Sonic Mania Plus. Now, I've seen some shit on this. I'm a big Sonic fan, love the Sonic games. I was a big Sega guy growing up, you know, love me some Sega. And this Sonic Mania Plus is going to be definitely a game that I would like to fucking play. You've got Sonic, of course, and you've got all his friends and some new characters coming to the scene, man, on this game. So be looking out for that. Sonic Plus. Another one, that I am interested in seeing is Dead Cells. Dead Cells is, I think, a multi-platform game as well, but it is definitely coming to the Switch, and it's something that I would definitely play on the Switch as well. It's an RPG game. It's a vintage-looking, you know, pixelated RPG game as well, and it looks fucking awesome. There's a lot of footage out there on that game. Definitely check it out, man. Dead Cells. Another game of mine that I would love to see, well, it's coming out, is basically called Code of Princess EX. Now, they had a Code of Princess on the 3DS, and I actually have that game and love the game. But this one looks to elaborate on that graphically and just all out production, and it looks fucking amazing. It's definitely something I want to play, man. It's basically, if you guys have heard of a game called Guardian Heroes that was out on the Sega, I think it's a Sega Saturn, man. Sega Saturn. Guardian Heroes was one of my favorite RPG games growing up. I wish they would do a remake of that, man. Just the HD version. I would love it so much. Guardian Heroes. But basically, it's the same guys who did Guardian Heroes, and it plays sort of like Guardian Heroes. There's like three layers to each stage, so you can hit a button and jump to the front line, and there's enemies on that. Then you can hit a back button, you'll be in the middle, and then hit one more, and you'll be like on the third tier in the back. And I just love the game. And the fact that everybody you come across and you beat in this game, you are able to play as them after, you know, you beat the game. They're all playable characters. And then you can play in an arena mode where you can play versus all these guys. You don't have to play just as the heroes and shit. It's just so fucking awesome, man. A dope, very, very dope RPG game. I'm anxious to play this one. This is definitely going to be a buy for me when I get my Switch. Yeah, games are starting to pile up, man. Really are. Another one is Freedom Planet 2. That's coming out in 2019, so we still got a little ways. But it's definitely an RPG platform, kind of a hack and slash, if you will. Don't know too much about the game, but I saw some clips, fell in love with the play style, and is definitely something I would be interested in playing. It's called Freedom Planet 2. Now, there's been rumors, I'm going to say this, there's been rumors that the GameCube could be coming to the Nintendo Switch. We could be getting some GameCube games. That would be awesome if that happened. Nintendo just renewed the basically the patent on the GameCube. Now, that could mean a number of different things because they've done this before. They've renewed patents on shit and have not done anything with them. So this could just be them just redoing, you know, just wanting to keep their shit and that's it. But most of us are hoping that that is not the case, that they're going to start putting out GameCube games, you know, classics out eventually for the Nintendo Switch. And hopefully they will, man. I'm very, very, you know, reluctant, you know, to buy a Switch yet. I mean, there's reasons for me to buy it and play it now. And, you know, but, you know, it's not anything that's just like, yo, I have to have it. Because one of the things is I keep thinking that they're going to come out with, you know, a slim version or something. And then, you know, with more battery life and everything like that. And I'm going to be pissed when they do. Because for me, the Nintendo Switch is a handheld to me. It's not a system that I'd play on my TV. It's just not. And that's just how how I play mine. I'm going to play mine on the screen, you know, on the screen it comes with. And that's pretty much what I'm going to do. But, you know, who knows? I'm going to get one, though. I'm trying to ride it out. If it does, nothing changes by the holiday season, that's probably what I'll end up doing is getting it, you know, getting it in holiday season, man, for sure. By then, there'll be enough games, plenty of games to grab I can take. And you know, a lot of things will be out by then. And then, you know, I can have it then. That's probably what's going to end up happening. But, yeah, man, that's the news on Nintendo. Some quick things for that. And looking forward to some of these games on Nintendo. Now there's some news here with Google, man. Google is supposedly going to be getting into the console market. The release time is supposed to be around 2020, the same time that we're going to see, you know, the PlayStation 5 and the new Xbox coming out, the new system coming out. So, you know, if Google gets in here, it could be a fucking wrap for a lot of motherfuckers, man. They could shut shit down because Google has so much money. They have more money than God. And, you know, they can get, I see them going after all the top developers. I see them offering top dollar and I see them trying to do some shit. If they come out with a system, I mean, fuck, it's going to break a lot of banks. I'll definitely say that because, if they come out with a system, I'm definitely going to probably be fucking with that. But, you know, I'm jumping the gun a little bit here, but you know, we're going to find out if it's viable. And trust me, we all know if it's going to be possibly a viable system. You know what I mean? We're going to be looking at the tech. We're going to be looking at everything it has to offer. They saying that it's going to be a lot of streaming involved in it. They're saying it's going to be some kind of hardware involved in it. And we're going to see what we're going to go from there. When they say streaming, that's where things get a little shaky. Now, if they're not selling games that you can play offline, then definitely I will not be fucking with them. But if they do, then, you know, that's another thing. Now, and streaming, if they mean by, hey, well, you know, you get this hardware and then you download the games, you know, we don't sell anything physical, but we're going to download them and you can save them on your box. That's another story. You know what I mean? But as far as, you know, online only, this online only shit, you know, it's not. I like to play offline a lot of my games. That's why I like open world RPGs, because they don't require you to be online to play them. You can play them anytime, anywhere, and you don't have to have internet. And, you know, because the internet is flimsy sometimes. We all have had stories of, you know, servers down or the server's not working right now because we're doing maintenance, all of that shit. So that's the type of thing I'm talking about there. And, you know, we'll see when the thing unfolds and more time passes how it goes. But this could mean big things for these other competitors out here in these streets. So get ready for that. Be looking out for Google's hidden game console coming to a home near you. All right. On that note, I'm going to skip and jump on some anime real quick, guys. For some reason, I cannot find the episode of Boruto, the follow-up episode to what just happened a week ago. And if you guys don't know, I mean, Naruto was taken captive because he was trying to save the village. They were in the Chunin exams and some shit went down. I mean, shit's getting real out here in the world of Boruto, man. It really fucking is. It's getting real out here in these streets. And basically, you know, Sasuke and some friends, including his son, Boruto, had to go and use the Sharingan and use Sasuke's abilities, man, to go in and pull Naruto out. And it was epic. I mean, this motherfucker had to be powerful if, number one, he took on Naruto and Sasuke full power. You know what I mean? It wasn't a game. It's not a game in these streets. And basically, Boruto finally realized, you know, what his dad was doing all this time. Finally realizes, because if you guys have been watching Boruto, you know that, you know, Boruto had a lot of animosity, man, towards his dad because he was never home, and he was never home because he was the Hokage. I mean, and, you know, being the Hokage has lots of responsibilities. You know, you have to watch over the entire village, you know, and he took that as like, you know, my dad didn't care. My dad didn't this, did that. And that was not the case at all. And, you know, that's what we had to deal with. And he finally realized that his daddy was, you know, just trying to make everything right and do what was good. You know what I mean? And I can't explain it all to you guys. You just have to check it out. If you're not watching Boruto, man, you sleep. Okay. Yes, it did start out slow, but it's gotten so much better. It had to introduce you to everybody and get you to know, you know, who these kids were and what they were about, you know, going forward, man. And they did it in such a graceful way, in my opinion. Was a little bit long winded at times, yes, but they got it done. And now we are officially in, you know, where shit is going to be getting real, man, here on out. Okay. It's been like that for a while now. So definitely check out Boruto, man. I had to brush on it, but I cannot find the follow-up episode. Maybe they skipped a week or because I can't find it. I cannot find it. Been wanting to watch it. But on another note, My Hero Academia, My Hero Academia is definitely polishing up to be some sort of phenomenon, man, in the anime community, man, in these streets, in these anime streets. You know, All Might fucking died, if you will. I mean, you know, the whole time you're watching My Hero Academia, he's hinting at he's going to die and he doesn't have much time left. Technically, he did die because All Might is no longer, you know, All Might. You'll never see All Might again, at least for the foreseeable future. I mean, you know, now all you're going to get is the teacher, you know, death of a hero, birth of a teacher. Now his frailed, you know, withered version of himself is all that is left. And he can no longer, you know, use his abilities to save or protect anyone. You know what I mean? So now he's just going to be, you know, Deku's teacher and mentor and basically, you know, that's his duty now, you know. That was one of the best episodes, the fight with him and One for All. I mean, I'm sorry, All for One. It was fucking epic, man. I mean, his body was failing him in the middle of the fight. I mean, he was basically, you just had to see it, and most of us have, at least glazed over it, if anything else. There's a lot of shit going on now in the show. They're keeping everybody in dorms because, you know, they don't want them to get caught slipping like they did, you know, oh boy, at first. And you catch them at home by yourself solo, it's going to be way easier to catch somebody and, you know, do harm to them. So they keep everybody together in the dorm and everybody works together because everybody's not ready. Everybody's still in training. No one has reached their plateau yet. And that's probably the best way, you know, it should be. Everybody fighting together, everybody close. So if you take one, you're going to have to take us all type shit, you know, until everybody fully develops. I'm interested to see how everybody's going to develop, though, and then, you know, what they're going to do. Because I'm sure once everybody reaches their peak, like, okay, you're strong enough to do your thing and become an actual hero. Now we're going to send you here to this city, or we're going to send you to this area, you know, and then they have their own adventures out there. They could do so much with that. You could do so much with this going forward, as you could do one-offs on characters, you know, on what they're doing, what's going on in their neck of the woods. I would love to see, you know, we got this movie coming up in August the Two Heroes movie, the My Hero Academia movie, and I would, you know, basically his prime, you know, in All Might's prime, you know, All Might is big favorite of mine in this anime, and Deku as well, and I would just love to see more of his adventures, you know, from when he was younger, and you know, actually what actually happened to him, you know, to lead to his, you know, this. To lead to his demise, you know what I mean? To the basically the beginning of the end of All Might. Like, I want to know exactly what happened and see what happened, and really want to see other, you know, exploits and things he did. You know, what made him who he was. You know, they could do an excellent spinoff on this, not just a movie, but an actual, you know, an anime series on him and his life. You know, when he was doing his thing, when he was in his prime. You know what I mean? And then you would also be able to focus on his other characters, like the number two. The number two dude is the fire guy. He's fucking awesome. I mean, and he's a dickhead. So for him to have respect, the respect he has for All Might, you know, that tells you some things too. So the rivalry between those two guys, and, you know, like I said, more backstory on, you know, on All for One. That would definitely be interesting to see. They could do so much with this, man, going forward. So I'm very excited for the future of My Hero Academia, man. And, you know, I just had to brush on those things. That's My Hero Academia talk. Definitely go check that out if you have not seen it. But there's so many anime out there, man. And I don't know where to begin or where to end. I'm still watching Claymore. I'm in the middle of Claymore right now. It's going hard. Claymore, these are some bad bitches, man. They are. They're women only, and they fucking, Claymore is basically the term of these, a mixture between half human and half creature, and basically they were created to basically remedy the problem with the creatures that are out there in these streets, and basically they eventually turn, the women, these Claymores eventually go full-blooded creature and turn, so when that time gets near, they send another Claymore out to kill her before that happens. And they can request, the Claymore can request who they want to kill them and you know, basically take them out of their misery. It's definitely dope. It's the main character is a chick named Claire. And I am definitely interested. It's kind of dark, of course. It's got a dark tone to it. And it's definitely worth watching. I mean, amongst the thousands of other anime out there in these anime streets, you could be fucking watching. Yeah, I'm going to be starting Black Clover soon. And I'm also going to be starting another Netflix original from the series, the Fate Stay Night series. They just announced another series. Yes, a 10 episode series. So, yeah, stumbled upon that the other day. Going to be checking that out. So there's a lot of things on my plate, man, as far as, you know, anime to watch. I'm still waiting for the Naruto, the English dub, to finish. I'm going to watch it again, and I'm going to watch it all English dub this time. And I think we've got another set coming out in at the end of September or August. I can't remember. But so we're almost done. 500 episodes is almost complete. We're like riding around the 450s range. So, yeah, man, when that I can actually pretty much start now. I think I could go ahead and start now and then, you know, just take my time watching it, not binging it like I did the first time and doing it that way as well. Because I'm going to go Naruto first and then finish that. And then I'm going to go Shippuden and, you know, rock that out like that. So, you know, at a slower pace, of course, you know, maybe a few episodes a day type of thing, maybe a couple episodes a day. You know, I love the series so much, man. I can't wait to rewatch it in English all complete. And by the time I get to the end, hopefully that the last couple of discs should be out and I can, you know, complete the set. But yeah, man, that's what I'm doing right now on an anime tip on anime end, guys. If there's any anime that you guys would like to request or would like to, you know, comment about or suggest that I check out, man, definitely, hey, feel free to do so. I would love to fucking know. I like dark anime, you know, with some dark tone to it. And, you know, I like a little action in my anime as well. You know what I mean? Yeah. You know, so let me know. Like I said before, you can hit me on social media all day long, Twitter, you know, at Studio MacGyver, Instagram at Studio MacGyver 79, Facebook at Studio MacGyver as well, man. So holler at your boy. Also, I have to mention this before I get up out of here, guys. Go, don't forget, if you need some dope anime merch or some gaming merch, you need some cups, you need some hats, you need some dope ass t-shirts or some sweatshirts and hoodies, you know what I mean, for when it gets cold or whatever, you know, you need to check out Beautiful Nerds, man. BeautifulNerds.com is your one-stop shop for anime merch, and it's growing every week. New stuff always being updated weekly. There's some dope shit on there, man. There's actually a fucking Ambu Black Ops collection on there that's fucking epic as fuck. Hats, sweats, hats, hoodies, t-shirts, man, it's fucking awesome. Definitely check out the Humble Black Ops shit they got on there. But it's www.beautifulnerds.com. Beautifulnerds.com. They also have an Instagram. There's a Facebook and I think a Pinterest as well. So definitely check them out for your anime needs, players. Show some love and support. And after that, man, that's it. I thank you guys for joining me. Sorry that I didn't deliver a podcast last week. You know, things happen from time to time, and every once in a while that will happen. But, you know, I will be back next week with more anime talk as I devour more anime, because I have more time now that E3 is over. And I want to say I love all you guys, man, for listening and staying down with me from day one, man. A lot of you guys have been hanging around since, you know, since over a year ago when I started this thing, when I sounded terrible, when the production value was a little bit on the low end and all of that. But now, you know, you guys are still riding with me, and I appreciate that. And all the new listeners as well, man. I mean, you know, I love anime and I love gaming, and this is just a passion of mine. You know, I don't care if nobody listened to the show, I would still probably be doing it, if it was just for one person, even though that's not the case. But even if it was, I'd still do it because I love it so much. And I'm going to continue. I'm going to be old ass guys in his 70s watching anime and playing games. I mean, that's just what it is. And, you know, I'm a nerd for life. So with that being said, guys, you have been listening to Studio MacGyver's Dragon Ball and Video Game Podcast. See you next time.